So today, I wanted to kind of demystify and break down moments with your host family that count as work and moments that don't count as work, where you're literally just being part of the family. It's Edwina. Before I even get into things, this is probably the subject where it is really great if you are with an agency. Because if you go through an agency versus going through a website, you have a contract and guidelines to help you establish certain hours where you're working to make sure that you're not being overworked. Because unfortunately, a lot of the time what happens with families that don't go through agencies is that you don't have these guidelines. Families are like, oh, you ask for off when you want, but then you want to make a good impression, so then you never ask for off, so then the family thinks you're okay with that because you keep working without saying anything. So it all comes back to communication. But if you have an agency, you're one step ahead of the game in that you have this outlined contract with hours where you're working and you're not working, and that goes for vacations, for the school year, and for other time off, like over the weekends and things. So you have your agency to lean on. And of course, if you have any other questions about this topic, we also answer some of these questions on the channel, so go check that out for sure. So I want to start out with what it was like to live with my host family when I was an au pair in Paris, for example. I worked with 5 kids. That sounds crazy, but it was not that bad because I only watched 2 of them, and the 3 older kids helped me out when it came to like discipline and things. They were my sisters and my peers, and they were just helping me manage the 2 kids. But those kids, for example, went to school Monday through Friday. They only had half days on Wednesdays. So on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, I picked them up from school at 4:30 and I worked until dinner around 8:30. 8 o'clock when the parents got home. On Wednesdays, they sometimes didn't have school or they only had up until 12 o'clock. I would pick them up and then work the rest of the day. So that's an 8-hour day. It was definitely long, but this is pretty normal in France. And so it was kind of nice as well because they had activities. They both had tennis, they had judo. We would go to the park on Wednesdays because the other kids obviously didn't have school either. So we would schedule play dates and things like that to kind of take up their time. And a lot of the times it was kind of nice because we got to chill. In terms of vacations and jours fériés, which means that holidays, they don't have school on these days. There were some days where I worked and there were some days that I didn't work. For example, in France, every 6 weeks you have a 2-week vacation from school. And what usually happens is you work one of the weeks and then you don't work the other week, but you get paid for both weeks in order to compensate. And it's true that you're working really long days, but it kind of compensates because you do get off time. So, topic number one. On vacations, when are you working and when are you not? Every family is different, and we say this a lot in our videos, but it's true because not only is every family different, but every vacation is different. For example, I went to Bordeaux with my host family and the grandparents were there. So there was a shared responsibility between me watching the kids and then the grandparents watching them. And so I had a good balance between off time and on time, a good balance. I mean, there were times where I didn't really feel like I was responsible and I was just there to kind of enjoy my time with the grandparents and with the kids. There were other vacations, for example, where I completely wasn't needed. And actually they had invited me to the countryside just to have me enjoy another place in France, which I really enjoyed, but at the same time I was with my host family. So it was kind of weird. Looking back on it, this doesn't count as work. It felt like work sometimes because kids are tiring, but I did that on my own free will and I wasn't actually needed at the countryside. There were other adults that were there and it was my choice to go out there with them. I've worked other vacations as well where I am a full on a nanny schedule with my kids. I wake up with them when they wake up and then I go to sleep when they go to sleep. So I would work all day and I would ask for like a 3 hour pause in the middle of the day. Sometimes that was possible and sometimes that wasn't. That is complete work and it was compensated later with pay, but also I got more off days later in the month or later in the year. The biggest way you can avoid this problem with your host family. I'm gonna repeat this until I'm buried underground and dead, but communication. And the reason why this is so important with this topic specifically is because your host family doesn't realize a lot of the time that you feel like you're working. I remember when I was at my host family's apartments on Wednesdays, as I mentioned, I had two or three older siblings, host siblings, and the oldest was 15 years old, so sometimes she was able to do some of the child care for me in place of me. And sometimes on Wednesdays at the end of the day, I felt like I wasn't really needed. And so I communicated that to my host family and they were like, oh, we thought you were just there because you wanted to be there and because you were having fun. That was like half true. Yes, I wanted to be there, but I also felt like I was being pressured to be there. And so once I brought the subject up and I realized I had the right to leave and to do whatever it was in my independent life, it made the experience, if ever I decided to stay, a lot better because I knew that I wasn't working and I knew that my host family thought that I wasn't working either. And so just asking them and being more clear about the hours specifically that you're working and you're not working is really, really important. Some moments where you're not working, where it might feel like you're working, is eating your meals with your family. Especially in France, meals are a sacred time, and talking and just sitting in that space, and even if you're not talking, just being around your family, around food, does not count. Unless you're just eating with the kids. But if you're eating with the parents and their family, that doesn't count as work. If you're going to family celebrations like family birthday parties and family reunions and you're not watching the kids, you're there to get to know the family, that doesn't count as work. Technically, for au pairs, you should have one paid week off every 6 months. The great thing about being more communicative about your family about working and not working is that you get to establish and know when you're not working, and so that way, if you want to go travel and take a long weekend, you can do that and you don't have to guess. So, for example, with my first host family, I worked a lot over the summer, but they gave me the flexibility to take long weekends over the year. And that was kind of the give and take that we had worked out. And so that really worked out for me. But other au pairs do things differently. So you have to really find out what works for you and for your host family. And the only way you can do that is by starting a conversation about it and by asking them when they need you the most and when you can be more flexible with your time with your host family. Don't come at it with like an attitude of, I don't really want to be here, I don't really want to work, when can I be free? Because your host family is not going to react well to that. Try to put yourself in their shoes as much as you can and realize that they put a lot of effort into you, coming over, finding you, investing in Skype calls and everything, and they really want you to have a good time. So just knowing that and trying to remember that in your head is going to help make broaching these conversations and starting these conversations a little bit easier. At least that's what made it easier for me. And know that you're not alone. I've had a million awkward conversations with my host family. I spent lots of awkward periods with my host family, but it was through these awkward moments that we were able to grow closer, and that now I still stay in contact with my host family, and that's 6 years after I was their au pair. And that's because I put in the time and I communicated. I think I've drilled that lesson down into the ground as much as I can. If you have any other questions, you can always check us out on the blog and on our YouTube channel, Au Pair of Paris. I hope you're having an amazing day and that this video helps you. Thanks for watching. Ciao for now. Bye.